Today is day 7, the final evening of our youth week of prayer. I want to say a big thank you for all of you for making time to join our youth week of prayer. God has been with us throughout the week. God has heard our prayers, and God will grant our heart desires. We thank God so much for this privilege that we can meet once again to worship Him. We'll start our service this evening with SDH 248. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for this privilege that sinners as we are, we can have this opportunity to come before you in prayer. Father, we pray that, Father, you cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And Father, we commit our heart desires into your hands. That, Father, you be with us and grant our heart desires. We pray that, Father, during the week we've come before you with our prayer requests, we know that, Father, you answer them for us. We pray that, Father, even as we have this service this evening, we commit our speaker into your hands, that, Father, you bless him and let him speak words from you. And, Father, speak to us this evening. We thank you, O Lord, for hearing our prayers, for we've prayed in Jesus' name. Amen. Our brother Ken Dazi would speak to us this evening. But as usual, before Ken speaks to us, we'd sing SDH 573, our theme song.
The mountains height over the stormy sea. It may not be at the battle's front, my Lord, who have need of me. But if by voice he calls to part. my hand in thine. I'll go where you want me to go. I'll go where you want me to go. Yeah, Lord, oh mountain or plain or sea, I'll say what you want me to say. Yeah, Lord, I'll be what you want me to be. I'll go where you want me to go. Yeah, Lord, oh mountain or plain or sea, I'll say what you want me to say. Dear Lord, I'll be what you want me to be.
Good evening, lovely people of God. I thank God so much that another week Youth for Prayer have come to us again in the year 2021. And we thank our previous presenters, in the person of my brother Aurelius Lamte, who gave us a message, Lord, I will go, guide me. This evening too, we are taking another message, that is, Lord, I will go, strengthen me. And then this message gives us a case study of a very popular character in the Bible, in the person of Joshua, who take the reins of Moses, and how fear was a challenge in his life, and how he overcome that fear by the grace of God. So at the end of the message, we were able to understand and know how, as young people, as families, as people of God, and also the leaders in our respective positions, sometimes when challenges and difficulty comes our way, how we can able to overcome them and able to make impact in our generation. The story says that fear, or don't be afraid, it is said 365 times in the Bible. Or fear not, it is said 200 times in the Bible. And all the characters in the Bible, both small and great, they are all affected by this human frailty, that is fear. Our dear brother and a very strong man of the faith, that is Joshua, also had that difficulty. His challenges were in threefold. One, in replacing Moses. Two, crossing the Jordan River. Three, able to conquer the land that the good Lord has promised them so many years. The story says that when Moses pass on and the rain falls on Joshua, she was so much afraid. Because Moses, as we all know, is a big name in the life of the Israelites. And Joshua, being an trained apprentice, and the good Lord asked him to take his children to the promised land, was a big, big, big thing for him to cross. Yes, as young people, sometimes our families, our parents that we depend on might kick the bucket early in life, and we need to feel the reins of fatherhood and motherhood and take care of our younger siblings in the family. It's not easy. Sometimes when we get opportunity to go to secondary school, it's a new community. So many things are happening. Fear is everywhere. But glory be to God, when all these challenges were beckoning at Joshua,
the good Lord, who always is magnanimous and kind to humanity, assure him of his presence, protection, and guidance, and assure him that you need to spur him on, that you not be afraid, but it's possible, so that you not anticipate any fear. So after that, God gave him three special guarantees that will enable him to overcome the fear of failure. That is, number one, the assurance of his promises. God has already promised the land of Canaan to Abraham so many years ago, to Isaac, Jacob. So there's no way Joshua has to be afraid of him taking the reign and going to conquer the land. The good Lord was on his side. Definitely, victory was guaranteed. The certainty of the presence of God was with Joshua. So Joshua chapter 1, verse 9, I quote, "Do not be afraid, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." So these are the words that the good Lord spoke to Joshua, and he strengthened him to know that, yes, victory is assured, and so therefore, fear should not be entertained. As much as challenges and difficulties are real in our face, the presence of God also is real when you believe and trust in God. So there's no need for us to be afraid. We need to hook on to God's promises, and victory will be ours. Finally, God gave him the word that, "Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you'll be prosperous and successful." For Joshua to overcome his fears, he had to do three things: accept, believe, meditate, obey, and live the word of God as it is. Friends, sometimes we are afraid because we don't know the word of God. Romans chapter 10, verse number 17, the Bible says, "Faith comes by hearing, and hearing no other word but the word of God." So once the word of God has reached us, and you know it, and Psalm 119, verse 130, it says that the entrance of his word brings light, and it gives understanding to the simple. Beautiful people of God, if you hook on to the word of God, it has so many promises that are real, that is relevant, that is so potent, that you can trust and obey and have a victory. Even though the challenges and difficulties are real in our time, in terms of job, COVID-19 has brought a lot of fear everywhere, in business, in family, in church, even the way you're organizing our church. It tells you that we are afraid that when the youth converge and we know we're able to, we talk and we touch each other, sometimes maybe this dangerous virus will affect us. That's why you're having all these beautiful programs on set for you to appreciate. So it tells us that fear is real, and also true, the presence of God is also real, so we can put our hope on that. Only on the word of God will give us enough strength to defeat fear. Hallelujah. For the word of God to become reality in our lives, we need to take three actions. And the first one is, first, accept its authority. We should remember that the Bible is the supreme authority of truth. It is order. It is the law. It is the standard that we need to accustom ourselves with. There's no book, no power, no ethnic powers that we can assign ourselves to, or association, or profession, that we can have trust or respect. But the supreme word of God is what dominates everything. When he said that in the beginning God created heaven and earth, And let there be light. It's an order. It's not ambiguity. So friends, if you want to trust something solid, all other grounds are sinking sand. The only ground that is solid and it can give me and you victory is the word of God. Now we need to accept and live by. Second, for us to have that ability to overcome fear, we need to internalize the teachings of the Bible. It's not enough to accept its authority, but to live by it daily. Many a times, we have that knowledge, experience of the Word of God. But as to how we internalize this Word to become part and parcel of our life, as God told Joshua that you should meditate upon the Word day and night, which is a very important period of our lives. When all said and done, we get home, we watch our TVs, we dine with the family, we discuss things. God said, remember me and read my word when it's night falls. When it's early in the morning, we need a word as we are exiting out to our businesses and our place of interest. The word of God is so important. And the third one, after internalizing the word of God, we need to apply the principle in the Bible. That's the only way we can overcome fear. Because some of the things, as periodically, or our daily Sabbath school was saying few months ago, the propagandist always throw certain things to us. That yes, God cannot do it. Our marriages is on rock, and we think God cannot do it. Our job is on the line. Our education, maybe our mathematics. Our English is not good. Our physics, our chemistry. But when you apply the principle in the Bible, that God, who is the author of all knowledge, and trust and believe in Him, as a student watching me right now, and maybe as a family, you're struggling with certain needs of life, and you're looking for solution. Friends, if you're able to trust and obey and apply the principle in the Bible, I can assure you, victory will be ours in Jesus' name. Yes, victory will be ours. There's no way there has ever been a time that the principle of the Bible has been applied to the letter, that God has failed that people. Let's pick an example of the woman of Zarephath. A very small dough that's left for her and the son to eat to die. And he obeyed, he applied God first principle. And after that, the result, I guess, is good as mine. So, as we go through day 7 of our youth week of prayer, we are encouraged to allow ourselves for the principle in the Bible to live within us and walk by it. And the tremendous results that will come our way, we have no idea. I can give you an example. When Daniel and his 3 friends live by the principle of God, that we not eat anything defiled, and they kept that principle. After the test, they were 10 times sharper than those who went to the other side. And I guess maybe there are other people who were taken to Babylon, which because of fear, which we are discussing this evening, they also ate. And the Bible gives records that Daniel and his 3 friends were 10 times sharper. So, what is stopping you to live by the word of God, to empower you, to encourage you? Another character, Joseph, a very fine character in the Bible. He lived by the principle of God, that why should I go for somebody's wife and then sin against God? Even though he was put into prison, but the resultant effect of his principle, holding the principle of God, the sanctity of marriage, that he don't defile himself with Potiphar's wife. He was being pushed to prison. But at the end of the day, he became the prime minister of a whole country, a stranger. That tells us that indeed, holding to the principle in the Bible have a great effect in our life. So whatever fear you're anticipating this evening, I call on you. Let's go on our knees. Let's ask the good Lord for power to overcome whatever fear that we anticipate in our life, whether in our family circle, in our financial settings, in our relationship with our friends and loved ones, at the workplace. You have a terrible character. The good Lord is here to strengthen you. I also encourage you, as in the season of prayer, to ask the good Lord to give you that discipline to go through His word each day of our life as we exit out to attend to our needs and our interests. I also ask to pray wherever you are, in your room or wherever you are watching me, to ask the good Lord the grace to apply the principle in the Bible as young people. If you cannot stand up for anything, you fall for everything. So that you live by that, says the Lord. Because in the end, those who live by that, says the Lord, is going to be saved into the kingdom of God. The last but not the least, in our session of prayer, I also ask us to pray and ask the power to go and share the word of God. Because indeed, when the good Lord has given us all this testimony and strength and abilities, it's for us to go and do His bidding. As Jesus said, day in, day out, I must be on the business of my Father. So we are calling all the youth, wherever we are. It's our responsibility, as the aged in the church, in the faith, are fading out. We need to ask the strength to go and share the word of God.
Thank you.
Oh.
Amen.
We thank our brother Ken for allowing himself to be used by the Spirit. I know we have been blessed, and God again will grant our heart desires. We'll close our session this evening with SDH 612. Gracious Father, we thank you so much for how far you have brought us. We thank you in a special way for being with us throughout the week, even as we spend time to pray and to learn about you. We pray that, Father, your Spirit will continue to be with us. We pray that, Father, you continue to fill us with that Spirit, that, Father, we will go where you send us. Father, be with us throughout the night and watch over us till we meet again on your holy Sabbath to worship you. We thank you and bless your name for all that you have done for us. We've prayed in Jesus' name. Amen.